When you say the memory is in kind of your cells or your remember or your cells remember, do you mean literally cells or do you mean also muscles and the extracellular matrix and just everything that's there?
The muscles are cells, the blood vessels are cells, every cell. Mm-hmm. So it's not a particular type of cell. All the cells, like if we just pause for a moment right now, all of our cells are in this moment, right? Mm-hmm. The nervous system then records this pattern. It's the great strength of the nervous system. It can take all, first of all, also the blood and the fluids are also recording. They're all over. Every cell has contact with blood, let's say fluid through lymph or CSF or something, but all the fluids are coming in and out of the blood. It's also recording, but it's recording differently than the nervous system. Because I have many years studied with people who have neurological challenges and other challenges, each person has shown me something about the nervous system. And that it's important that it forms patterns, but some of the patterns are now the problem because we're still in a past experience that's problematic. But the blood is also holding that pattern, as is the fascia, muscles, bones, all the things. Digestion, the microbiomes, everything is holding patterns. And we want to have those patterns so that we don't have to reinvent ourselves every moment. But then we also want to know when is there a pattern that is repressing a more natural pattern? And you know, is it natural, is it organic, you know, what do the words mean? By going back to the embryology, what I found is I've been able to, and with others, go underneath some of the patterns that are restricting before there was the restriction. At the same time, discovering the restriction. So let's say there's a lot happening now, fortunately, with trauma being acknowledged, and it keeps happening. When we recognize somatically in the cells what the traumatic pattern is, we have choice. At the same time, if our whole life is pivoting around that traumatic moment, our life is much more valuable than that traumatic moment. How do we cycle it around our life-giving force? So the trauma is only one piece of our life-giving pattern.